travelers, and welcome to Space Cadets. I'm your Most High Commander, Greg Proops. Stepping out of the Stargate and ready to bust a wormhole are the Alphas and the Omegas. Skippering the Alphas, a comedian whose legendary stare reminds me of a space bunny caught in the headlights of a star cruiser. Bill Bailey. And a sci-fi luminary whose performances as a certain Time Lord hold pride of place in the who's who of who's who, Sylvester McCoy. And keeping the housewives interested, a comedian who escaped Planet of the Accountants and who proudly possesses less hair than a Wookiee let loose in an IMAC factory. Fred McCauley. Providing initial conflict, the Omegas, led by a man recently voted sexiest man on Red Dwarf. Although in the overall poll, he lost out to an android, a cat, and a hologram. Craig Charles. Comedian for whom Return of the Jedi is a touchy subject. He was turned down for the part of Jabba the Hutt for being slightly too big. Ford Kiernan. Craig's secret sci-fi weapon is so tough, she uses bits of Cybermen to fix her plumbing. In Doctor Who, she was on the box, in the box, and out of her box. Ace in Craig's pack, Sophie Aldred. Ack, ack. Doctor, who am I? Is the name of our next port of call. Like the plot of Dune, this one's complicated, so listen close. Two travelers are given a new exterior. Once mutated, they can ask questions to discover it. No TV shows or film names may be uttered, and their crews must only respond negative or affirmative. If you deviate from these directives, pain will be your only friend.
Promise?
Yes, Ensign McCoy, and we will see you on the punishment deck. Captain Charles, rise and assume the morphing position.
Am I an alien?
Negative.
So I'm a human being. I'm a human being.
Negative.
Am I half alien, half human?
Affirmative.
Half alien, half human. Well, like Jabba the Hutt sort of thing?
Negative.
More cyborg than alien.
So I'm not an alien. I'm a robot.
Affirmative.
All right. Do I go, what's up, biggie?
I'm sure you do, but not now.
Can I do it again, though? Okay, I've got a big plunger on my head, walking around going, I am a darling, exterminate!
No.
Am I in Doctor Who? I'm one of them...
Negative.
One of them...
No TV shows.
Okay. Oh, pain.
Come on.
Here's the pain stick. Remember its taste?
Am I an amalgamation of a robot and a man?
Yes,
so I'm a half robot.
Yes. Very affirmative.
And I don't go big.
No.
Negative.
FCP. That fella, you know, CP.
No. C3PO.
Yeah.
Negative.
Am I from the 70s?
Negative.
60s?
Negative.
50s?
Negative.
You're from the 80s.
I'm from the 80s then?
Yes.
I'm from the 80s. Negative. Am I a movie star?
I found my job, go on with it!
Affirmative.
Affirmative.
Robocop!
Bingo!
Well done. And Captain Bailey, prepare to be morphed.
Oh, yeah. am I a human?
Affirmative. Negative. I don't know.
God's sake.
Negative. Negative.
If you don't know,
you start as human.
Yes. I start.
See?
Am I an unreal character? Am I a comic book character?
Affirmative.
Right. am I grossly over the normal size of humans?
Well, people have been telling you.
Are you talking about this?
Of course I'm talking about this.
Affirmative.
Right. Okay. Am I a different colour to normal?
Affirmative.
Affirmative, right. So would I be green?
Affirmative.
I'm colourblind.
Yeah? Oh, all right then. I'm huge, big bloke like that. Green.
Affirmative.
Shirt ripped like that.
Affirmative.
And then I'd go...
Yeah.
Like that.
Affirmative.
I don't know. Could be anyone.
Anyone
got
an apartment
Pete Shepard on a rough night. It's got to be the Incredible Hulk.
Yeah. Yes! Affirmative! Can I move back again?
Well done.
Our two teams are each shown a life-threatening climax to an old movie serial and are simply asked, how did they get out of that? Alphas, you're up first with some Flash Gordon.
Have got to do, isn't it? That's kind of, you know that thing in his hat? What hat was it? As he went down, he pulled that and there was a gas canister and it blew him up like a big balloon and they floated off and drank champagne.
Yeah, and little tiny snacks.
I want to live in your universe.
Maybe.
I really do. I want to go to a place where you pull a thing and you drink champagne later.
Yes. Well, that's life, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sort of. Usually I pull something, fall asleep, and have a lager.
All right.
How did they get out of that?
They caught one.
Was it the ramparts of Windsor Castle and they landed on Fergie, who was hanging around for scrap? And they were all fine.
Possibly.
Yeah. Walked off.
There was a big moat and they landed in the water.
All right, then, if you're happy, let's have a look. What an imaginative and gripping ending to that particular Flash Gordon episode.
It was champagne. They fell in the champagne.
God love you, Mr.
In your case, lager, but never mind.
And now for the Omegas, a special treat in King of the Rocket Men.
Getting there for another shot at us. Keep going.
How'd they get out of that?
How'd they get out of that?
I don't know, but they found the black box, and the guys turned around on the black box and were saying they'll never hit us from that distance.
So the other thing in the black box was, I thought Peggy Sue was your best track, Mr. Hawley.
It's one of those Saturday morning things. They probably weren't in the plane by the time the bullet reached it or the radio reached it.
They had their jolly parachutes on and they all floated off.
Did they jump out?
Yes, I think they did.
They parachuted out to safety a split second before the ray hit the chap.
Absolutely.
Jolly good idea.
I think so.
Or we don't care.
Well, here's one in the eye for you, Mr. Rocketman, and here we go.
It's Al.
Yeah, whatever.